And Joel Skousen of worldaffairsbrief.com was kind enough just to pop in with a quick news update. I don't know his particular view yet on Benjamin Netanyahu's visit or on what he thinks is really going on with the real power alliances. Are things breaking down for the West with their backing of al-Qaeda groups to take over Syria, blowback, or is it part of a larger plan? And is Netanyahu clearing the way for a joint strike with Saudi Arabia and then to give the West plausible deniability so that Obama and the United States cannot have its interest hit by Iranian retaliation? And would Iran buy that? So is the triple cross about to happen? First, we work with al-Qaeda against multiple Middle Eastern countries, rename it ISIS, double cross them, side with Iran, and then triple cross Iran. What does Joel Skousen, with all of his contacts and world research, think is happening? We'll find out now. Joel?
Hi, Alex. Good to be with you. Let me give you some background here, going back to 2004. There was an uninvited insider to a top City of London meeting of globalists. They didn't realize he wasn't a globalist. He was one of the financial experts in the City of London. He sat in on a meeting in 2010, and he heard them discuss their displeasure that Israel, that had been assigned to attack Iran since 2004, had not done so. And one of my sources in Israel says the reason they haven't done so is they feared Syrian retaliation. And so they basically put pressure on the United States to say, you've got to get rid of Syria before we'll attack Iran. And so that's what put the U.S. on the road to arming and funding jihadists through Saudi Arabia, Qatar, and Bahrain, so they could have plausible deniability. That's what Benghazi was all about, is shipping arms to the Syrian jihadists in order to overthrow Assad. And then, as you know, we've talked about before, that program of the ousting Assad got derailed by Kerry indiscreetly saying or giving Syria an out at a London press conference a year and a half ago, where he said, yeah, we wouldn't attack if they gave up their chemical weapons, and they did so. And so it set back the U.S. Program. That's why they had to create ISIS to have an excuse to go back into Iraq, go back into Iraq and Syria in order to take down Assad. That hasn't happened yet. But what you hypothesized, I think, is right on, Alex. That is, there's a triple cross going on, but it's really kind of a triple deception going on. Israel has leaked to Aretz Sheva, which is Israel News Network, normally a very reliable right-wing network, news network, private news network in Israel, that Obama was going to threaten to shoot down Israeli airplanes if they attacked Iran. That was completely bogus, completely disinformation.
Yeah, that's insane. I mean, that would be political suicide.
It would. Not only that, I mean, you'd have a tough time with American pilots shooting down Israeli pilots who are the best in the world in terms of their, top flight abilities. They fly the same airplanes that we do. They have the same type of IFF, or identification friend info. You'd have a real, but it was total bogus disinformation. The reason it was put out is, as you say, to give plausible deniability to the United States that not only were we not involved with Israel, we even threatened to shoot down Israeli airplanes if they did so.
And by the way, you're a former Marine Corps fighter pilot, so you know what you're talking about, just for folks that don't know.
That's right. I know what the Israeli tactics are, the best in the world. But the point is, the U.S. would never threaten to shoot down Israeli aircraft because of the Israeli lobby here in the United States. But that was disinformation. But what it shows is that Israel is getting closer to attacking Iran, probably with Saudi Arabia. I know they have clearance already to go through Saudi Arabian airspace to do that attack. But the U.S. seems to be really setting itself up for deniability that we don't have anything to do. Now, I don't think that Iran will buy this. I don't think that it will spare U.S. Retaliation against U.S. forces. And I don't think the U.S. wants to be spared. I think they want to be retaliated against Iran. Then they can join with Israel to finish off the military of Iran. Remember, the purpose there is not to occupy Iran. That would be very unpopular in the U.S. The purpose is to take down Iran militarily, because they're the only Muslim nation that is on the verge of becoming self-sufficient in arms, rockets, aircraft, weapons, artillery, drones. No other Arab country.
So they only want to cover with the American people so that Obama doesn't look like a warmonger. So this is all complete theater.
That's right. Absolutely, Alex.
Well, that put nice bookends on it. You know what's scary? I can't disagree with anything you just said, and that's basically what I've been saying. And again, I'm not a fan of these radical countries either, but at the same time, just the deceptiveness of all this, the manipulation of all of this, and then the most unsavory groups being funded to run around and commit all these atrocities. We know a lot of it's for television, but they are going through and really doing some terrible things. What is the end game in all of this, Joel Skousen, and where do you think it's going?
Well, the end game is to take down Iran. As I say, they want to make sure that Iran is completely neutered in terms of its ability to produce weapons and arm the rest of the Arab world. They've got Israel under their thumb, Saudi Arabia under their thumb, Turkey's under their thumb, and Syria, when it goes down, hopefully they'll be able to control that with controlled the jihadists now, which probably are Israeli agents, Israeli Arab agents that have been trained to go in and do that. I think even the speech of Netanyahu was part of this political theater attempting to, and all kinds of leaks came out about how the Obama administration was not in favor of his coming, and the Congress invited him despite the White House displeasure. This is all political theater. There's no way that the White House was really protesting Netanyahu's visit. But the end game is a major Middle East war, will not accelerate to World War III, but I think it will create absolute hatred against Israel and the United States among the Arab world, which is part of the rationale for eventually attacking the West, creating hatred among the world, both in the Serbian world and in the Muslim world against the United States, so that when Russia and China finally attack the West, that they will feel justified.
So it's another suckering, like World War II, suckering in the Japanese. If you pull back from this, I'm just sick of everyone being obsessed over Israel and acting like they actually are the dominant factor, when you can see more and more that the forces running the United States and Europe are giving the orders to Turkey, are giving the orders to Israel, are giving the orders to a certain extent to Saudi Arabia, though that's really incestuous. We'll have to have you back soon to do a whole hour on it. Thank you, Joel Skousen, editor, worldaffairsbrief.com.
My pleasure, Alex.